Hey guys, James here from the forums, and this is your Cook to Endure June monthly challenge, limited hunting weapons. So, I went ahead and I made myself an atlatl. What I did was, and I'm sorry I didn't get this on video, but it just started pouring on me and I just had no time. I went and I found myself a branch that was like this. It had a Y in it. Cut it here. And I went ahead and did a diameter reduction, which you guys would have learned carving a tri-stick in the bush bomb, STL. Made myself a handle, nice and round. Did this all with a Mora knife. Went, reduced the diameter here a little bit, and then I don't know if you guys can see this, see the scorch mark on there, but I tried to heat straighten it a little bit, and I got it pretty good. I got the tine in line with the end of the handle. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's lined up pretty damn close. So what I need to do is make some darts. I'm going to use some bamboo. Normally I would use dry bamboo, or I would temper this bamboo, but it's been raining like crazy today, and it's probably 100% humidity, and close to 102, 103 degrees. So fire isn't going to be something I'm going to be able to do today. It's going to rain again any minute. So I'm just going to go ahead and use green bamboo and make some dum-dum rounds, you know, some stunning rounds. So what I need to do is I need to dial in the tine, because the tine is going to determine the release point for my my darts. So let's start by cleaning up our darts a little bit, and then we'll dial in this tine. So I did what I cut myself up. Bamboo staves. You want them relatively flexible. See, it's pretty flexible. And a lot of guys make the mistake of putting the heavier end back and the narrow end forward. And what happens is, when you throw it, you get this. It'll fly this way. And we want it to fly this way. So we wanted the heavier end forward. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to take my knife and I'm going to open this up a little bit to accept the tine. So I'm going to bevel the inside. Clean this up. I'm going to bevel the inside here, if you guys can see this. Just like that. To accept the tine from the atlatl. Alright, and these are just super quickies. All I'm going to do is, because they're just dum-dum rounds, I'm going to leave the ends blunt for now, because I've been using them to stun like a rabbit or a squirrel or something, and I don't necessarily want to pierce it, but if I did want to, what I could do is go ahead, and with bamboo what you do is you kind of carve one side out, until you get a point, and then you would fire harden it. Make just a small round here, just like this. And we'll put a little point on it, see if we can't get it to stick into something. Ground maybe, just like that. And generally what I would do is I would have left more of this node so I could put it at a much sharper point, but like I said, because I was making dum-dum rounds, and because I'm not tempering or heat-straining these, because just can't get a fire going today, tried earlier and just could not find anything dry, even the inside of the deadwood was just soaked, so, make myself a little point here, and see how she flies. So I was gonna normally go this way because there's a trail back here and I don't want to kill people, but I don't see anybody coming. So I'm gonna go ahead and load this one up like this. Here. I want to go for distance first to see how she works. Distance is good, no flights, but the fly rate. Let's get that and try it again. a little bit closer to target. I think my time is a little bit too long for this. So let's try. This is a little bit heavy.
It does, to be quite honest with you.
Let's try throwing this one.
Stay there, stay there.
That seems to work all right. I killed that tree. But I split out the ends. My bamboo, I left too much.
What I should have done was left a node here.
So what I might do is cut her here. And we'll make some more darts and then we'll have a little throwing contest, shall we? Fellas, we're back. We made a bunch of darts. We're gonna give this a whirl now. The first one I'm gonna go for distance just to see how well the time releases and how good the actual atalata works. So we're going to try and get to the other side of that creek over here. So if you want to come behind me in here, Tim. Pivot. Alright, so the distance is there, but it's like that.
So let's try some of the other darts to see how we do.
Alright, so we're gonna try attempt to kill this violin tree over here. Alright, so let's see how we do. We're gonna aim for, if you guys can see it on the camera, there's a brown spot in the middle of the trunk of that tree in the base. That's what we're gonna aim for. Not terrible, not great, but not terrible. Well, I guess if I straighten the shafts, tune the tine a little bit, put some heavier arrow tips on them so they'll weight it down a little bit and put flights on them, I'd probably be a little closer. But you know what? For a 5-minute atalatal and dart setup, and I could probably hit something that's, you know, that's about 20 feet. Or so, maybe a little bit further than that, away, 20-25 feet. So to try and pick out a squirrel or a rabbit that I'm pretty close to, or for catching a fish, you know, spear fishing, I think it's good enough. The atalatal came out okay, so I think it's really tuning the darts and tuning the tine a little bit. But that's it, guys. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll try to squeeze in another one before the month's over.